Matthew, you did nothing wrong. Good luck at West Point, and we'll be looking forward to seeing great things for you in your future. Thank you for being with us.
Thank you, Mr. Hannity.
Thank you very much.
All right, when we come back, we have big news on Barack Obama's brand-new pastor, also more on the Rush Limbaugh controversy, and Governor Palin has big plans on the horizon. It looks like her political career is far from over. We're going to tell you about the former governor's next move. That's coming up straight ahead.
Remember when...
And tonight on our great, great American panel, he is a Fox News contributor. Tucker Carlson is back. He's an attorney, Democratic strategist, left-wing radical, socialist. Steve McMahon is here. She's one of country music's greatest stars. And her latest Time Life CD is My Turn, Tanya Tucker. Is the one and only is here.
Yeah.
Welcome aboard. Thanks for being here. Good to see you.
It's good to see you.
All right, we've got, let's go back to the videotape. We were talking earlier about my friend Rush Limbaugh and this controversy over his attempt to buy the St. Louis Rams. Here's more of him from his radio show.
I learned yesterday that George Soros might be in this group. Reuters had a story that George Soros is one of Dave Checkett's partners. I did not know that. Of course, Mr. Soros is well-known politically for his left-wing slants. His politics fits in perfectly, apparently, with what the National Football League is becoming. But I wonder if they know that he is also involved in a movement to legalize marijuana and how that will play as the owners decide whether or not he's fit.
Well, you know, this does raise a great point, Tucker. I mean, all right, what about all the players that have committed crimes or done things that have not put the NFL in the best light? They're still in the NFL.
You wouldn't want Rush Limbaugh to besmirch the sterling reputation of the National Football League.
Yeah. Look, I think it would be fair to say, you know, we disagree with Limbaugh's position on drug legalization or taxation or abortion. But his critics didn't do that. They said he's a racist. And they used lines that he never uttered to make that case. That buffoon on CNN, whose name I can never remember, the guy was always tasering himself, got up on CNN and said, these are things that Rush Limbaugh said about black people. And they were totally false. This is the tactic that offends me most. If you disagree with the man's ideas, debate them. But they never do. They write him off
you
as a bigot.
You had a former colleague that talked about, you know, putting a pellet in his head.
Wow.
You know, could you imagine if Sean Hannity talked about it? You pick any left-winger, I don't care which one, or anybody on the Fox News channel that is on the White House government-funded, taxpayer-funded website, could you imagine any conservative saying anything similar about any liberal anywhere? What would happen? They'd be calling for my firing today.
I think you'd be gone.
And he shouldn't say stuff. Come on, calling for violence against people, that is a pretty bright line. Yeah, you don't do it.
Yeah. Listen, I think actually Tucker's right about people shouldn't go after...
Hold on. Go ahead.
That's not what happened at the NFL meeting. That's not what happened at the NFL meeting. What happened at the NFL meeting was an NFL owner said... He said he wouldn't vote for him. Not because he's racist. Nobody at the NFL meeting said that. They said it's because he's controversial. Too controversial to be in their club. And, Sean, you know, I got to be honest with you. It's very difficult for me to get a sense of moral outrage about some wealthy white men saying to another very wealthy white man, you can't be a member of our exclusive white club.
That's what's going on here, Sean.
You know what's going on.
If that is the standard, then you should say right now that George Soros shouldn't be a part of this group.
You know what? George Soros maybe shouldn't be. You know, there was a guy, Howard Milstein, tried to buy the Washington Redskins about 10 years ago, and the owner said, you can't be in our club because we don't like you. They can exclude people for any reason. I don't want to tell the NFL what their rules ought to be.
But that's not the point. If they're going to say it's political controversy, then George Soros is in the same controversy.
There's also political controversy. And you know, I'm going to cite now Bloomberg.com. Some of the racially insensitive. I'm not calling him a racist. I'm saying he said racially insensive things.
Oh, you mean like
things,
Al Sharpton, which, who called the African-American mayor of New York?
Al Sharpton couldn't be an owner in the NFL. Al Sharpton couldn't be an owner in the NFL.
Well, he let them wait. This is where the hypocrisy comes.
Well, look at all the controversy,
Sean,
with the players. I mean, it goes all the way up, doesn't it?
They're so concerned about the prestigious image of the NFL.
The players are always...
Michael Vick wants to play in the NFL. Yeah. I think he should. Well, I think that would be good. If Rush wants to play in the NFL, I'll bet you they'll let him play.
I'll put him up against you, and he'll run circles around you, man.
That's a really fair point.
point. If you have Michael Vick, who I think should be in prison for the rest of his life for what he did to those animals, I really believe that. If you have him representing the National Football League, like who is beneath you? Like who falls below that standard?
Exactly. Hold,
excuse me for one second. It's a country club. It's white billionaires who get to decide.
What does white have to do?
No,
Tucker, over my head.
Tucker, what I'm saying is this happens every single day in America, and Republicans don't normally get outraged, except when it happens to Rush Limbaugh.
All right, you're a big President Obama supporter.
I am.
President Obama said, I have it on tape, white folks' greed runs a world in need. President Obama talked about typical white people. Barack Obama was part of a church with the black value system.
Are we here to talk about Rush Limbaugh, Sean?
I'm here to talk about double standards and hypocrisy, Steve.
It's not a double standard.
You know,
the NFL said he's too controversial to be in our club.
The NFL commissioner and one owner, one. There are a lot of other. How many teams are in the NFL, Tucker? Help me out here.
Quite a few,
32.
Sean. I'm glad you asked me that question.
32.
They should have a vote. And you know what? They'll vote him out. If Rush Limbaugh wants to stand for a vote, they should have a vote.
Right, but why do they? What is it? Just it has to be that club. I mean, who decided on that? I mean,
that's the rules. The NFL owners would decide, but only one, as I understand it, came out against them.
Only one so far, Sean.
They're doing here, you see, when liberals can get away with lying about what people say, smearing them, besmirching them, assassinating their character. It is a witch hunt. And you know what, Steve? Your liberal friends get away with this crap all the time.
Did he say the Crips versus the Bloods?
I don't know, but
did he talk about the NAACP? Did he talk about the NAACP buying a liquor store so they could practice robbing it?
What he said is the NAACP, liberal. The same NAACP.
Let me just make it really clear. You're allowed to attack the NAACP, which is a ludicrous organization, without being a bigot. I mean, that's a fair thing to say.
I'm not calling him a racist. I'm saying he's controversial, too controversial for the white boys in the NFL.
Come on now.
But football's controversial anyway.
Well, apparently not. There's
not
at least
anymore.
Standard. Michael Vick is in. Rush Limbaugh's out. Soros is in. Rush Limbaugh's out. I'm not as gracious
Sean,
as him. I've
football
had
team,
it.
Sean,
huh?
Football team.
All right, I got my
there
own.
There you go. There you go.
Hannity football. Right there. More of our great American panel. Straight ahead. And we continue now with our great American panel. All right, so here we have Obama administration officials working on regulating the financial industry and the financial system. They're beneficiaries of several millions of dollars in pay from Wall Street and private equity companies. It's been revealed. The friends of tax cheat Geithner. Justify this, Mr. Liberal, with all your...
Let's just think about how it was revealed. It was revealed on a government disclosure form, a financial disclosure form, which they fill out when they become part of the government. The money that they made in the private sector, Sean, on Wall Street, not too far from here. And I can't believe you're being critical of them for being successful. That's what they were.
Now they come in
the administration, and they try to figure out how to prop up Wall Street.
I have to agree with what Steve is saying. I think people have a right to get rich. Most people kind of want to get rich, and mazel tov to those who succeed. What bothers me is when you don't pay your taxes, because that's unfair.
While at the same time
espousing higher taxes for others, and moreover, the idea that these are people who represent an administration that has a moral problem with high salaries and is attempting to regulate private sector salaries, they ought to be ashamed of
themselves. Private sector salaries funded with government money. I don't think any of their private sector salaries were funded with a penny of your money, Tucker, not a penny of your money.
I'm certainly not defending the firms that took government money. I don't think they should have in the first place.
Are you going to defend the bonuses that they're giving with government money, taxpayer money, the people who watch the show?
I don't think government ought to intersect with the private sector in that way.
Billions of dollars in bonuses to Wall Street for the people that brought down Wall Street.
Almost unique among people I know, I've been against this nonsense from day one. I was against the bailout. I was against the stimulus package. I don't like any of it.
I'm just saying,
thank you. But I am saying that as long as you're going to be regulating other people's salaries and frowning in the sort of, deeply disappointed way at the greed running amok in American life, you better not be taking home $5 million for light labor, because that's exactly what's happening.
And you know what they did? They took home $5 million for what might be light labor, but they made a lot of money for somebody, and they did it before they entered government service.
Hold on.
They did it before they entered government service. I can't believe I'm sitting here with all these Republicans saying they shouldn't be able to make money on Wall Street and then go work for the government.
Because you're missing the big point.
Okay.
It's your friends that are the ones constantly lecturing us about the evils of capitalism.
No, they're not.
Wait a minute. They talk about the evils of the banking industry. They want to regulate them to death.
Hang on a second. Yes, they do.
They want to dictate CEO pay.
Yes.
And meanwhile,
with taxpayer money, yes.
With their fat cat connections, guys are living off of the regulations that are going in place. Sean. Wait a minute. Because of their connections to this tax cheat that runs the IRS right now.
Hold on a second. These are guys that came from Wall Street. They met Geithner there. And I had, by the way, I had the same concerns you did about Geithner's unwilling, his tax problems. But apparently,
you still supported him.
I still supported him because I didn't think it was a huge deal.
You don't ever want to come out against the Democrats.
In the face of a huge financial crisis. Let's just remember what they inherited.
He was the only one that could do it.
Remember what they inherited. Well, that's what a lot of people thought. That's what a lot of journalists thought. I was never convinced of that myself, but that's where we went. And guess what? They fixed it. They invested money.
They fixed what?
The Dow just passed 10,000. You probably were cheering.
10% unemployment.
But the financial system did not collapse. It was on the verge of collapsing.
The taxpayer
money.
10% of the country's unemployed.
Taxpayers' money is being paid back. The viewers who are funding those billions in pensions.
You travel the country, and you sing before large audiences of people.
Oh, yeah.
A lot of people that work really, really hard. When they hear, you know, my friend Steve over here defending a tax cheat head of the IRS, his cronies making money because of their connections to this tax cheat, you know, what does your audience think?
Well, I think it's very offensive. It really is.
They're sick of this.
Yeah, they are. They are. You know, and gosh, hard-working people and their money's just, you know, it comes in and goes out before they even see it, and they have someone like this do that. I think it's very offensive.
No, you can't explain to me at all without, frankly, Stephen, we've been friends a long time, without sounding crazy or
let me try.
Explain to me how Tim Geithner, you supported him even though he's a tax cheat, is in charge of the IRS. How do you explain, how do you justify that man getting that position?
Listen, there were a lot of people at the time he wouldn't have gotten that position unless there were a number of people who believed he was the only person who could do
the
it.
Only
I don't know
person.
Why.
That's the only one, Tucker.
Let me just tell you something. That's
kind of the chosen one.
What if the poor man's chosen one? There's a messianic quality to this whole administration.
What if the poor man cheats?
But hold on a second.
He goes to jail.
That's right. He goes under the jail.
And the rich man pays big fines. This is what's happened, though. We've invested in Wall Street. We've corrected many of these problems.
I don't want to hear this lecture.
The taxpayers are getting repaid with interest.
How does a tax cheat get
the
position and you justify it?
I don't know how he got the position.
Why don't you just take a moral stand and say, you know what? Barack Obama should put somebody with the moral authority to enforce IRS laws by doing it himself.
Regulated.
I think if the circumstances had been different, Tim Geithner wouldn't have been confirmed, but they weren't. It was a crisis.
Tucker.
He fixed it. The government is getting its money back,
right,
and taxpayers are getting rewarded.
I don't honestly think in the midterms and in 2012 people are going to care at all about the Dow. Right. It's jobs.
We got to run.
No care about Tim Geithner either.
Thanks for being with us. You're going to be on IMUS tomorrow. We'll see you then.
Yes, I am.
On the Fox Business Network. That's all the time we have left this evening. As always, thanks for being with us.